Michelle Stanley, and I'm the flute professor at Colorado State University, and I'm going to be talking to you today about the All-State excerpts for 2019-2020. And we're going to start today with the Anderson 24 Etudes Opus 33. We're going to first start talking about the dynamics, because as you look through this, it's a very beautiful etude, it's very musical, and the dynamics are the thing that's going to really make your performance pop. Be very careful to pay attention to all the crescendos and decrescendos, and make a really good difference between your mezzo forte, your crescendo to forte, and your piano dynamics. In particular, look at measure 15. There is a subito piano on the second 16th note of the first beat. Up to that is a crescendo, so you should crescendo all the way to the high G at a forte and drop back down on the A natural that follows. The next thing we'll talk about is breathing. In the version that you find online, there are check marks printed in the part. Those are great places to breathe. However, if you look in the actual edition of the etude book, you'll notice that they're not there. Put the breaths in pretty much after every tied note. So for instance, the second bar after the B flat, the tied B flat, take a good breath there. After bar 4, the C is a great place to breathe, and in bar 6, the B flat. Then in the second half, after the double bar, you'll find the D natural followed by the D flat. Take a breath after the D natural. You can find other spots to breathe that are a little bit more natural after that. Musicality is a very important part of this etude. Be musical, find your interpretation, and don't be afraid to play your ideas on the page. I think the one really great thing to do would be to use vibrato. So if you're comfortable with vibrato, throw that in on the long notes. If you're still working on vibrato, work with a teacher, try to figure out how to do that with your playing, and insert that into the excerpt. Learning how to play vibrato on the flute can be a very challenging thing to do. I think there's a couple ways of doing this. First, if you don't know how to play with vibrato yet, maybe consider just listening to some flute music or listening to this recording, and maybe try to emulate what you're hearing. So let me show you an example of a B flat with vibrato. The idea of vibrato is that you're taking the sound waves, you're taking the air, and you're manipulating it so that there's color to the sound. It's like frosting on a cake. How you do that, however, if it's hard for you just to mimic that in your own playing, is that you might want to think about what is moving the air. So what is actually moving the air for vibrato is the vocal folds in your throat. So as you're blowing air and it's leaving your body, these vocal folds here are vibrating and manipulating the airstream. A word of caution. That does not mean that the muscles are engaged and that it's very tight. It's a very natural experience to play with vibrato, so you want to make sure that the muscles aren't too tight in the throat. If it's really tight, it'll sound like this. That's with the muscles engaging. This is with the vocal cords and the vocal folds just manipulating. The next excerpt we will be working on together is the Kohler Etudes from the 25 Romantic Etudes Opus 66 book published by Kalmus. This is on page 17 of the book, and it is number 16. The first thing we want to talk about with this etude is just the overall look of it. So when you look at these etudes, make sure you're kind of seeing the big picture, the things you're going to need to be working on, whether it's dynamics, whether it's the technique, maybe articulation. So we'll hit those topics today on this particular etude. The title of this etude is Cantabile a la Moderna, which means singingly and modern. So you'll want to find out for yourself how you would like to interpret that particular marking. I think it's important to maybe start with dynamics with this one because there's not a lot on the page. So notice that there's really just two main dynamics with one diminuendo. The dynamics start at forte, and then you'll see the next change in dynamic is in bar 13, and that is a piano dynamic. All the way from bar 1 through 13 is sustained. So make sure you play forte all the way throughout. Do not dip your dynamic at all. And then consequently, when you play the piano dynamic, keep a piano all the way through the allargando until we get back to the forte dynamic at the a tempo. Secondly, let's talk about accuracy and clarity. So this is a very technical excerpt. This is where you let your technique shine. So you have to make a decision about what tempo that you would like to play. On the excerpt, it is marked in the directions that you can play this between quarter note equals 96 to 112. You should choose a tempo that you can play everything perfectly. Do not sacrifice the technique just to play it faster. It will actually be more harmful to your audition if you play faster and sloppy than slower and clean, always. I like to play this at 112 just to show you what the top tempo sounds like, but please feel free to play this at 96 if that is where you are at. Also, go for clarity and effortlessness in your technique. Go practice slowly through the hard sections until you can work them up to a faster tempo. Another aspect to think about in this excerpt is the changes in tempos. So notice the first change in tempo is marked in measure 18. But in measure 17, there's nothing written. Because it says a tempo in measure 18, make sure you slow down the measure before. So put kind of a natural retard in that measure. The next spot is going to be in measure 22, where it says allargando. Allargando is a slower tempo than allegro. So let that measure broaden so that the next measure, which is marked a tempo, measure 23, can go back to our allegro maestoso tempo. And finally, for tempo changes, the last two bars is marked largo. And largo, as you know, is a very slow tempo. I like to think of this as slower, but I really like to think of this as dramatic. So think about the drama of the last two bars rather than just a tempo change. The articulation of this excerpt is also important to pay attention to. And there's just a couple spots that I want to point out. Overall, in the beginning, the slurs that are marked are really interesting because they don't always match the beaming. So make sure you put those tonguing spots in the first two lines. In the third line, which is measures 9 and 10, there are staccato marks. I like to play this with much more detached sound with the staccatos in bars 9 and 10, and then go back to the regular articulation in bars 11 and 12 and further. Bars 19, 20 and further, you'll see lots of great accents and staccatos as well, so make sure you bring that out. And those are your tricky measures, those are your technical measures, so make sure you don't forget to play the articulation as marked there. And finally, just play this excerpt with total brilliance and the sparkling sound. Make sure it sounds effortless and clean and go for beautiful clarity with the way that you interpret this piece, and good luck to you. Thank you. thank you so much for watching this video today, and I wish you a lot of luck on your Allstate band and orchestra auditions. If you would like to learn more about those two auditions, please see their websites. If you would like to learn more about Colorado State University, we invite you to check out our website as well. And you can also find me on social media at michellestanleyflutist.com. Thank you.
Thanks so much for watching this Colorado Allstate prep video. If you have any questions or concerns, please visit music.colostate.edu for more information, including the opportunity to schedule an individual visit with the School of Music, Theater, and Dance. Good luck on your audition.